And me and Capone are sitting ringside, and there's an entire audience that's shouting your name. They're going, Bonnie, Bonnie, Bonnie. Miss Parker.
How about a dance? What do you say? I've got some moves that I'd love to show you. Let's find a spot and dance the night away.
That is one of my favorites.
How about a dance? It's always fun. Come over here, let me get to know ya. Can't beat a band to lift your spirits high. You look so handsome. How about a dance?
Woo!
Let's make a star.
Sing it, sugar.
Music like this can really throw ya. You'll lose the blues, and you may lose your heart. Tonight is the night I've been waiting for. Even the moon looks just right. I'm sure the crowd will make room on the floor when they see you.
Your mama's home. Why didn't you tell
me
your mama's
Mama.
Something? That's something.
Bonnie, what on earth are you? Who are you?
You see ya.
Mama, this is Clyde Barrow. He's a cousin of my friend Charlene's.
Evening, Miss Parker.
Why are you in my house this time of evening?
Well, you see, I was just
passing
through.
He's just passing through on his way to Ohio to begin a job in printing.
Printing, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Not many men have jobs these days.
No, ma'am.
You should consider yourself very, lucky.
And I do. I am very grateful. Who plays you, okay?
My husband did. God rest his soul.
Amen.
That was nice. Where did you learn to play?
You know, a colored boy taught me when me and my family lived under a viaduct.
You lived in one of those camps?
Yeah. You know, Pa was a sharecropper over in Henderson County. We lived there till the land dried up, and we lost our farm. Headed out for Dallas, Texas. Lived in a damn tent for 3 years.
Well, Clyde, you may sleep on the sofa. There's an extra sheet in the bedroom. I'm afraid we don't have an extra blanket.
Oh, that's all right, Miss Parker. Thank you.
Bonnie, I'll expect you up very shortly.
Yes, Mama.
Almost immediately.
Mama.
Your husband will be home, you know.
You got a husband?
Baby,
well, that ain't something you should tell a fella.
I had a husband. Went to jail about 3 years ago.
Still there?
No. Just not very interested in being a husband. Hey, come on, is that really what you want to talk about right now?
You expecting somebody?
No.
Oh, shit, it's the loss. Meet me tomorrow morning, 145 Oak Grove, over in Harrison. Okay, 8 o'clock. Whistle or throw something at the second floor window.
Okay, baby. Ted! What are you doing here?
I was just in the neighborhood following a prison break, and I thought I'd stop by, you know, and make sure you and your ma are okay.
No, we're just fine. Thanks, Ted.
Jeez. You know, the last time I was in this house is when your grandma died.
That was a long time ago.
I mean, she was wearing lots of makeup, but you could still see she was dead.
I hated seeing her like that.
And I remember how we both hid under your front porch.
Oh, eating buttermilk pie.
And playing cards. So I will pick you up Saturday.
Ted.
And keep the store locked. All right?
All right, Ted.
I think most folks would be shocked to realize just how unchristian you are in bed, Mrs. Barrow.
Why, Daddy, you hush that mouth of yours.
I am sure gonna miss that over the next 8 months.
The time you're away is going to fly by. You'll see. And I'll work. You know, the salon's still busy. No matter how bad things get, women always find money for their hair. You know, Eleanor's kids, they haven't seen real milk in over a year, but that woman, she gets her hair color done every 2 months.
I love you, Blanche.
I love you, Daddy. What in God's name is that?
I think it's Clyde.
Marvin Ivan Barra. You're using our home as a criminal rendezvous point?
Oh, come on, Blanche. It's just Clyde.
Which makes this a criminal rendezvous point. I want him out of here as fast as possible. You hear?
But he's my brother.
That man puts the hell in hello. You're like children with your secret knocks.
Hey, buddy! Oh! Made it. It's good to see you.
Are you okay?
Yeah, why?
You look like shit.
Oh, will you shut up? You know, I just slept in the woods. You read today's papers.
No, I didn't.
Read them for yourself.
Buck and Clyde on Barrow Town.
Hell yeah, man! That is us!
Clyde! What the hell does this mean?
It means we're on the front page headlines. Look right alongside Al Capone.
Well, damn.
Hey, do you remember when we saw Al Capone in the middle of the afternoon in that
white Model T Roadster?
That is gonna be us, Buck, out on the open road in a Model T. Maybe one of those MGs over in Europe. Did you know they have a 4-speed gearbox with a top speed of 65 miles per hour?
Damn.
Ain't no car too smart for me. Got the whole thing figured out. Two-door hardtop Model T, limousine or runabout. You put me behind the wheel, then stand well back like a Cracker Jack. I'll get your heart pumping.
Ain't no car that you can't
drive. Hell no!
I would bet my life on
thank
that.
You.
Hot rod roadster, pickup truck, 40 miles and nothing flat.
ain't nothing better than the drive through town with the throttle down. Watch them old folks jumping.
Watch out!
When I drive, I'm in love, I'm alive. And I forget about everything, eh? When I drive, I can breathe 65. I won't pay the line no mind.
Hell no.
They'll always be behind. And man, that just feels great.
Hey, look, there's danger up ahead. Here comes a curve.
Don't stop tugging at my sleeve. Just hold your nerve. Give me a foot and get an open road. Then watch me explode. Hey, look at me. I'm driving. When I drive, I'm in love, I'm alive. And I forget about everything I hate.
When you drive, laugh just flies when you drive.
We are the heroes who those people look up to. And brother, that feels great. I can float.
I can float.
I can fly.
I can fly.
This is how.
This is how I
want to live. I want to die. I'm in love.
I'm alive.
I'm alive when I
She is here.
Who's here, Clyde? Clyde!
Is he gone?
I think he's coming back.
Why?
I think he went outside to get a girl.
A girl?
I mean, that's what he said.
When on earth did Clyde find time to...